must find Baranor before it's too late.
He is bait, Talion, and he will live until we arrive.
Death would be relief to these men. The purpose of this camp is torture.
Save me! Stay here.
Many thanks.
I never thought I'd escape this place.
Just
Goodbye, dead. Ranger, and thank you.
Better look for whoever did this.
And under God. But you just walk in. Don't start thinking you're any different from this bunch. I'm going to slice open every single one of your arteries and turn you into a glorious fountain of red.
Stand, man of the West!
Serve the Bright Lord!
Command me, Bright Lord! Bright Lord! As you say, my lord!
Not feeling well. Just kill me. I can't.
You want some?
Yeah!
You will serve the Bright Lord!
I'll follow every command!
Whatever you desire, sir.
Let it end. Please.
We must leave!
Thank you, Rachel.
You're injured.
It's nothing. You saved us. Again.
You were right. Staying in Mordor is certain doom. But I cannot leave.
My lady. Then we will be doomed. Together.
Caius. Dog.
You! You're dead.
Get him, boys!
You cannot touch me, outsider! must attack swiftly, or the Garagors will give us away.
The Analects of Ruvenir is a collection of advice from a long-ago Gondorian swordsman. It includes a series of exercises he guaranteed would lead to triumph in every duel. Like all young Gondorian soldiers, I studied the Analects a great deal, and I learned two key things. One, Ruvenir's swordsmanship was undoubtedly better than his penmanship. And two, in Ruvenir's time, duelists were far more courteous than the orcs of Mordor. War ignores such niceties.
We got a Targ hiding round here!
A treatise on fine swordsmanship.
All too rare in these times. Such grace is lost on the denizens of Mordor.
Ah!
Minas Ethel held many treasures far grander than this necklace, though none more precious to me. When I was a little girl, I would sneak into the Great Hall and take this necklace from its locked cabinet, thanks to a loose latch that only a child's hand could reach. For hours, I would admire myself in the mirror, imagining myself an elegant lady of Gondor, much like my mother must have been. My father caught me eventually, but as punishment, I received only a lecture. Perhaps he didn't mind seeing his daughter in such finery.
I'm surprised this necklace isn't hanging from some orc's neck.
Perhaps their stubby fingers cannot work such a delicate clasp. Sadras. Here in Mordor, loyalty passes from orc to captain to overlord, and the chain of loyalty ends in a ring of power. Everyone in Mordor is ultimately loyal to a ring, but rings themselves have no loyalty. Their wearers and their makers would do well to remember this.
Kneel before me!
It is a fundamental truth of Mordor. The orcs have been here far longer than men, far longer than the Dark Lord himself, even. This place belongs to them, and in their own way, the orcs revere their heritage. We found this sword in a crude shrine, after all. Yet imagine what the orcs and Mordor could become if freed of the Dark Lord's corruption.
The orcs can temper. Wait, I'll give them that.
They produce weapons in mass, but they give little care to each one.
Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts. Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Thank you.
Sauron taught us a bitter lesson. Those in fair forms use grace to hide their true nature. That grace leads to trust, a weakness they can exploit.
Like the elves, Sauron values wisdom above all else. But for him, it is a cold, hard thing. He believes freedom is an empty virtue. He believes that Middle-earth seeks perfection in order. He believes that he will achieve what those before him could not.
She speaks the truth.
Never thought I'd hear you say that.